Hey there, welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Channel, where we attempt to demystify the disease and to empower you as the person with Parkinson's disease to reach your true potential. If you're 50 years old or younger and have been diagnosed with Parkinson's disease or suspect you may have Parkinson's disease or similar condition, this video is for you specifically, and it could be one of the most important videos that you watch. There are many reasons for that, among which are the fact that there are statistics I'm going to share that may surprise you. In fact, they may blow your mind in terms of the numbers that I'm going to share. You're going to want to make sure to stay tuned until the very end of this video to make sure that you hear the important statistics that I'm going to share with you so that you can take it and share it with others, especially those that have this misconception of PD being a disease of old age. Without further ado, let's jump into the video. So imagine this scenario. It's a dark night, you're driving by yourself, minding your own business. Maybe you make a rolling stop at that last stop sign. Maybe you went slightly through a red light. Whichever the case may be, a policeman sees you and pulls you over. Now, you have a clean driving record, you're not really concerned about anything. You cordially ask the officer why he pulled you over. He tells you about whatever moving violation he thinks you committed, and ask for your identification and so forth. In that process, he notices your speech sounds a little bit off, and maybe you're moving a little bit more than you should, or tremoring. Something tips him off that you might be intoxicated, or at least that's what he suspects. So he asks you if you've been drinking. Of course, you say no, because you're a responsible citizen. But he doesn't believe you. So what does he ask you to do? You guessed it. Field sobriety test. Now look, if you're 65 plus with Parkinson's or 45 and lower with Parkinson's disease, do you think that you'd be able to pass a field sobriety test if you were asked to do that today? I think we both know the answer is probably not. As you probably guessed, in our scenario, our friend with Parkinson's disease fails the field sobriety test. The officer takes him in and books him for DUI, under suspicion of DUI. Now, of course, a breathalyzer test will show that our friend is not intoxicated. Most likely will be released with an apology. Either that or they go to court and they throw it out. Regardless of the legal outcome, this is not an uncommon scenario. And what I've described has happened enough that organizations like American Parkinson's Disease Association actually have a wallet card that says, "I have Parkinson's disease," and explains that so that the officers and law enforcement are not thinking that someone's intoxicated just because of the way that they talk or move or behave. That's just one example of how important it is for the public to understand more about Parkinson's disease. The statistics I want to share with you by the end of this video today are the ones that will be able to empower you to share this knowledge with others, especially those that may be involved in law enforcement and other officials, so that the public will finally hopefully start to come around to the fact that there are folks that are younger than 50 years old that have Parkinson's disease that may very well still be in the workforce. They may be mothers, fathers, husbands, wives, and so forth. In fact, we know people just like that, and there are friends of the channel that you've seen. Ian Rodriguez was one of the friends we had on the channel recently, and he was diagnosed at age 26. He's had Parkinson's now for over 20 years. Chuck has had Parkinson's since he was 47. In another video that we did recently, you heard from Ian, who was diagnosed at 55 years old, which is a little bit older than our cutoff we talked about in this video, but still considered young onset. Point being, there are many individuals just like them all over the United States, and we're going to talk about some real numbers. I keep mentioning that. I promise I will share those with you, so I'm not going to keep you hanging, but I do want to talk about a couple of things briefly before I share that with you. I just want to emphasize how important it is for the public eye to be changed on this when it comes to persons that are 50 years or younger with Parkinson's disease. If you're 50 years old or younger and you have PD, and especially if you're a parent, you could be the parent of a college-aged child or a high school-aged child, somebody who's just coming into adulthood and you're their role model. There's a lot of import to that, a lot of impact that this has on people's lives. We've hinted in other videos about the potential impact that Parkinson's can have on one's sex life. You could have problems with erectile dysfunction for men, and for women, libido can be extremely low, if not non-existent. Not only that, but some Parkinson's medications can cause addictive behavior, and sexual addiction can be one of those issues. Dopamine agonists are one of the medications that could be linked to such behaviors. Folks with PD under 50 years old are going to be living with the disease really quite a long time. So for those folks, medication is going to become less and less effective over time. Problems like dyskinesia and dystonia are going to be very apparent in those with young onset Parkinson's versus those 65 plus, even though those problems can be present in anybody with PD. That's one of the reasons DBS is such a viable treatment for those under 65 or especially under 50 who are diagnosed, because they are going to be living with it so long that carbidopa, levodopa, or other forms of levodopa they're taking may become less and less effective, to the point where medication really isn't treating the symptoms in an effective way any longer. And final thought I have about this is that there are many folks with Parkinson's that are younger, 45, 40, whatever the age might be. If they're under 50 category, even if they're between 50 and 65, they may be in the workforce. And they are. I know many of them that are still working. And some folks really don't want their employers to know. And for good reason. Many employers may have a false belief that that individual may not be capable of fulfilling their job duties simply based on the knowledge that they have the diagnosis. The fact of the matter is there are people that are truly afraid of anybody finding out. And that's simply because of the fact that they're younger with Parkinson's and they may suffer consequences because of that, if not discrimination. I'm sure there are many other things that I haven't mentioned that folks could chime in and talk about, especially those of you who have young onset Parkinson's. Before I share the statistics I promised, I also wanted to mention that our friend of the channel, David, with Life with Parkinson's Disease, he's also somebody who was diagnosed in his 40s and who is chronicling his journey with Parkinson's disease. So his channel would be great to check out, and I'll put a link to that. Now, the statistics. So here are the facts. 10 to 20% of those diagnosed with Parkinson's in the United States each year are younger than 50 years old. Additionally, of the approximately 90,000 people in the USA that are diagnosed with PD every year, between 9,000 and 18,000 of those individuals will be young onset Parkinson's disease. That comes directly from APDA and their statistics on young onset Parkinson's. So think about that, 10 to 20%. At the outset, 20% is 1/5 of all the folks living with Parkinson's disease in this country. And there are millions of them. I may be wrong, and I'm not a statistician, but my sense is that this number is growing and it's probably going to continue to do so. Why do I think that? The main reason is because environmental exposures are still there that have been there for decades now. And it seems like more and more people are being diagnosed under 50 years old with Parkinson's disease than ever before. I say seems like, but I feel like the numbers that we quoted today really do bear that out. So listen, if you're younger than 50, watching this video, you have Parkinson's disease, and you have friends like this guy.
I don't know, man, isn't that a disease that like old people get?
Now you can tell him exactly what the facts are and where to look them up. Thanks as always for watching. Please do like this video if you enjoyed it. Share it with other people and be sure to subscribe to the channel. We're going to have a great conversation with David Gebhardt from Life with Parkinson's that you're not going to want to miss. And you're going to want to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you don't miss it when that video drops. As always, thanks so much for watching. And until next time, be empowered. Man, I wish I could learn to talk better. Disease of old age.